Hello, my name is Mary Bronner. I am the Division Chief of Anatomic Pathology and Molecular Oncology at ARUP Laboratories and the Department of Pathology at the University of Utah. The topic is circulating tumor DNA. It promises to change the way we practice oncology. It's going to be a disruptive force in what we do. And the second topic of today's discussion is a specific circulating tumor DNA test for lung cancer, which is the T790m mutation, point mutation in the EGFR gene, and will be the first to market of this digital droplet PCR assay. Circulating tumor DNA or liquid biopsy. This technology promises to replace the very expensive and hardship-causing biopsies and surgeries that patients have to go through to get small pieces of tumor for molecular testing. That's the way we do it now currently. It will also, in many circumstances, replace imaging, CT scans, MRI scans that patients go through for recurrence detection. And it's not just one CT scan, it's serial CT scans every 6 months for the rest of the patient's life in some circumstances. And it's not just one CT scan, it's a head CT, it's a chest CT, and an abdominal CT every time they come in for screening. Liquid biopsy or circulating tumor DNA in many circumstances will replace these approaches to oncology. It's incredibly exciting and will change the way we practice medicine. Another potential use of circulating tumor DNA is to detect whether chemotherapy is working and not just waiting 6 months with a CT scan, which is what we do now, after we give somebody chemotherapy, but we can test them immediately post-chemotherapy to see whether their circulating tumor DNA levels are responding. So that time frame of a window of 6 months to immediate will be a major step forward for oncology. Targeted real-time detection of resistance to chemotherapy drugs and for cancer recurrence is what most people envision when they think about liquid biopsies, that we can serially monitor these patients by testing of plasma. It's the plasma fraction of blood that contains the circulating tumor DNA. And by serially testing these cost-effective and far less invasive blood tests, we can detect in a more real-time way, in an early way, when the recurrence occurs. And early detection has been long proven to be a mainstay of successful oncology. I think the most exciting part of circulating tumor DNA is a biological aspect. Currently, we test tumors for molecular abnormalities by taking a tiny sample from a large tumor and doing our molecular testing. We know that tumors are very heterogeneous, so that situation leads to sampling error. If you don't happen to test the exact right portion of the tumor, you're not going to get the result that the patient may need for a successful chemotherapy. The change to this with circulating tumor DNA is that we're using perfusion sampling, where the blood perfuses the entire tumor, samples DNA from the entire tumor, every cell. And not only that, it samples everywhere in the body so that if the patient has multiple metastases, you're not just sampling one tumor, you're sampling all of the tumors. So it's whole body sampling, whole tumor sampling by perfusion, which will hopefully eliminate the problem of tumor heterogeneity. So just some background comments on lung cancer itself. EGFR is a very important cancer gene for which targeted therapies have been developed in lung cancer. Overall, in 2015, new cases of lung cancer in the U.S. amount to 221,000 patients. And similarly, there's a very high cancer death rate at 158,000 expected in the year 2015. And this number is astounding, 158,000 deaths from lung cancer in 1 year. If you combined all of colon cancer, all of breast cancer, and all of prostate cancer, and all of the deaths from those, you would not reach the number of deaths that occur from lung cancer. So when you look at lung cancer, the whole universe of lung cancers, about 85% are what is called non-small cell lung cancer. And that's the subset of lung cancer that has the EGFR gene activation. Now, it's activated overall in lung cancer in about 10 to 35% of patients. In Western populations, the numbers are a little less, 10 to 15%, and in Eastern Asian populations, the numbers are a little higher, 20 to 35%. But overall, say approximately 20% of lung cancers are going to have a mutation in the EGFR gene. And what we're targeting here are adenocarcinomas, that subset of non-small cell lung cancer. So what happens now is that these patients are treated with a tyrosine kinase inhibitor. EGFR is a tyrosine kinase, and these inhibitor drugs block the proliferative biology that the EGFR gene gives the cell when it's activated. So by blocking this, it's chemotherapy. There's a number of tyrosine kinase inhibitors that have been FDA approved, including erlotinib and others. The problem with all of these tyrosine kinase inhibitors is that they're highly effective. They work at least 60% of the time on lung cancer, which is an amazing, amazing advance. But unfortunately, after a mean of about 11 months, almost 100% of these patients develop resistance mutations to these tyrosine kinase inhibitors. And thereafter, their prognosis is dismal. Well, along the lines of turning cancer into a chronic disease, new drugs have been developed. They're currently in FDA trials, FDA phase 3 trials, and have very exciting results. And these drugs target a new mutation that develops in tumors in lung cancers called the T790m. And this is an acquired mutation during their chemotherapy with the first generation tyrosine kinase inhibitors. What happens is the T790M mutation is responsible for 2/3 of the resistance that develops to the first generation tyrosine kinase inhibitors. So these new T790M specific chemotherapy drugs are now targeting that mutation and have an equally astounding effect on the tumors at about a 60% response rate. And there were two articles published back-to-back in April of this year, 2015, in the New England Journal of Medicine on these two compounds that are now in phase 3 trials. So it's very exciting. The way we traditionally monitor all of this diagnosis and treatment of lung cancer by chemotherapy is we start out with a surgery or a biopsy to get a piece of tissue. That's invasive, that's expensive, that's very difficult on the patient. We then treat them with tyrosine kinase inhibitors if they're found to have an EGFR mutation. Most commonly, it's a deletion of exon 19 or a point mutation in exon 21. Regardless, they get treated with tyrosine kinase inhibitors, and then we wait. And we get a CT scan, an MRI scan of the brain, of the chest, of the abdomen. And repeat that and repeat that over the average of about 11 months that patients receive remission therapy on the first generation tyrosine kinase inhibitors. If a metastasis or a recurrence is detected by the CAT scan, it has to be rebiopsied, which again is invasive and difficult for the patient, and then so on and so forth. We biopsy, we do CAT scans, we biopsy, we do CAT scans. This is highly invasive, incredibly expensive, and difficult for patients. This is the promise that circulating tumor DNA offers, which is instead of doing these invasive surgeries and biopsies, you just do a blood test, the so-called liquid biopsy. And because we've developed a monitoring test that's very low cost, we can do that test serially to have a real-time understanding and perhaps even earlier information about when patients recur so that we can change their medication, change their chemotherapy, change the approach. we'd replace all those CAT scans and all of those biopsies with blood tests. From DNA extraction to results, we're looking at about 3.5 hours. And time is of the essence in these oncology patients. The difference between hotspots and panels is an important point. Panels have a role. Panels are used at the time of initial diagnosis to get a profile of the cancer, to use for monitoring. But when you want to do serial monitoring tests, they have to be cost effective and rapid. And that's what the digital droplet PCR brings to this problem. So in summary, ARUP's validated digital droplet EGFR T790m assay is a test that requires only a simple tube, either of blood for plasma detection of circulating DNA or CSF. So we can test either plasma or CSF. The samples can be up to 5 days old. They have to be collected in a special tube called the BCT tube or the Streck tube and can be kept at ambient or cold temperatures. It has 100% specificity for the T790M mutation. It has 94% accuracy in our hand. And the only reason why it wasn't 100% accuracy is because we were comparing T790M detection in actual tumor tissue in the same patient to T790M by this digital droplet PCR plasma assay for our accuracy data. And there was one patient who had brain metastases but had been on a tyrosine kinase inhibitor and had no peripheral metastases. So their tumor tested positive for T790M, but the TKI had sterilized their peripheral blood from tumor, and it was only the brain metastases which was detected by CSF. So other than that patient, there's 100% accuracy of this test. It's 100% reproducible, and as I mentioned, it's incredibly sensitive, which is the key for circulating tumor DNA testing because there's so little of it floating around in the blood. And the limit of detection ranged from 0.008% mutant allele fraction to 0.397 in our hands across testing of approximately 50 patients. The ctDNA test is not only highly sensitive, it's quantitative. So you get an exact percent mutant allele fraction with each analysis, so you can monitor whether the levels are increasing or decreasing in the patient. So we've discussed the incredibly important topic in oncology, circulating tumor DNA, and how it's going to be a disruptive force in oncology and the way we take care of cancer. We've also discussed the specific digital droplet PCR assay for the T790M point mutation in the EGFR gene. This test is a lung cancer test, and not only does it identify recurrence of tumor in the blood, but it also allows for specific targeted drug selection for the T790M specific tyrosine kinase inhibitors. If you'd like more information on this test, please go to aruplab.com/oncology.